Well, Super League may be hitting its stride right now, but for the amateur game, the season finale is approaching. Next weekend, Lee East will face Queens from Leeds in the National Cup final, and the lads from Lee will be hoping for a clean sweep of trophies after winning the minor premiership and last Saturday beating Siddle in the National Conference grand final.
Under the baking sun, the climax of the National Conference League season. The favourites going in had to be Lee East, minor premiers, who already had beaten Siddle in four previous meetings this year. But form going into a final isn't always the best indicator of how a game will turn. On this occasion, it was the early touchdown just 6 minutes in that gave the first hint of how this particular final was going to turn out. Gareth Pemberton squeezed over in the far corner, putting Lee on the score sheet. 3 minutes later, the first of three tries from Gary Middlehurst. Somersaulting his way to 4 points here, extended to six by Ryan Peters. They turned up the heat 12 minutes later when Ryan Fieldhouse ghosted through a wilting defence to score. By now, the game was looking rather one-sided, especially when, 3 minutes before the break, the defence melted away once again to let Middlehurst in for his second. Half-time and 24-0, it would take some hot stuff from Siddle to grasp the initiative. They started the second half with more energy and the hint of a battle to come. This time, Lee East were facing the sun and it certainly seemed to blind them to Hoyle's straight run through the line to the in-goal. But unlike the sunshine, there were few more rays of brightness for the side from Halifax. Two Simbinnings in the space of 8 minutes put them under more pressure. And then this try by Blackburn within the last 10 minutes was pure consolation, who was cancelled out soon after when Middlehurst crossed for his third try. If the temperatures weren't hot enough, the match reached fever pitch as the final whistle approached. This fight leading to the Simbinnings of one from each side, but the resulting penalty sealed the win for Lee East. Final score, 37-10.
I thought we went about our business in a professional manner. We had a game plan, and I think we stuck to our game plan. We kept our discipline, and I think a little bit of ill discipline set into the Siddle side, which I think it cost them at the end.
First half, I think we blew them away. I think conditions suited us, fast play, and just try to keep rolling, get them points on board and carry on scoring really. But I think we did well. I think everyone turned up. I think Gaz Middlehurst were awesome today and fully deserved his man at match.
I'm over the moon, really. It's not just a single one-man performance. All 17, everyone has been unbelievable today and all through. This has been a long season, 26 games, but we stood up today when it counted.
Another trophy for Lee, but it might not be their last. This weekend, they take on Queens in the National Cup final in the seaside resort of Fylde. And if they put on a performance like this, they might just make winning look like child's play.
Yes, sir, a big weekend then coming up for Lee East. And as Angela mentioned, it all happens at Fylde, although they're calling it Blackpool Bonanza. But that's Blackpool just down the road. And at the Woodlands Fylde's ground, should be a great weekend. That game is just one of the matches going on there. A big weekend and culmination of the season. But behind the scenes, there's a lot going on, or there is an important issue being considered for the amateur game.
Yeah, there's a consultation process taking place. They're calling it the big debate. And it's discussing what time of the year Community Rugby League should be played, both at youth, junior and open age. And I suppose there's three proposals, really, for players and coaches who are asked for their opinion. One option available is a split season where they start in September but don't play over the months of December, January and February. And then, obviously, the season will drag on then to June. That's one possible scenario. Another one would be to have a summer season where they start in March and play through to November, which would be a change for a lot of the amateur sides. Or, finally, I suppose, to stick with a winter concept and play as they do from September through to May. So I think it's really interesting, and I'm delighted that the Rugby League are trying to gather the opinions of so many players and coaches, because ultimately they're the ones who need to decide when they want to have their fun.
But for the moment, there are issues to be resolved this coming weekend in Fylde, so I hope you enjoy the Blackpool Bonanza if you're there. But we'll take another short break right now.